after a long gap, we are back again. So sorry, we have been absent for a week or so, but some commitments happened. So, but anyway, good to be back, and good to be back with an interesting video this time. Thank you, Farhad, for coming in on this podcast. And so this time, you know, I think the tables have turned, because you know how often we keep saying that, okay, Bollywood should not make remakes of, you know, classic Malayalam or Tamil films or any South Indian films. They should not touch it because it will lose its authenticity and it lose its essence. And now, you know, it's the other way around. I mean, Malayalam cinema has come up with the remake of Andhadhun, which is supposed to be one of the greatest thrillers ever made in Indian cinema. And it's not just Malayalam cinema, but even Telugu cinema couldn't keep from making a remake there as well. They made Maestro, which came out recently. So, first question that I want to put out to you is, why? What was the need? Other than financial gains, what possibly could they have gained with these both remakes? And Bhramam being the focus here today.
So, hi guys, by the way, long time, yes. Why? I mean, I'm absolutely stumped. I mean, I didn't think, especially Malayalam cinema, you know, the level of films that they make and the originality that they have in their films. I didn't think that I would ever see a remake in Malayalam, you know. Telugu remakes do keep happening. You know, there was a recent also remake of Pink that had happened, which was Vakil Saab. So Telugu remakes are okay, but Malayalam remakes are not very often that you see. And I was actually shocked and a little curious as well as to, you know, how Bhramam would shape up considering the level that it had to match, you know, of Andhadhun, where, as you said, it's one of the better written thrillers of Bollywood. And it actually did go south, didn't it? You know, there's this term.
It went to south.
Yeah, it actually did. It did go south, actually. So, as they say in Hindi, there is a verb ki nazar lagna karke. So, you know, to hamari nazar lag gayi, aisa I feel, you know.
Ironically, it was Andhadhun, and Andhadhun ko bhi nazar lag gayi, dekho.
Exactly.
No, but I mean, even if you say that, you know, it's surprising to see Malayalam cinema making a remake because they're always coming up with new innovative ideas. If you were to, you know, put a finger to it that, okay, this might be a reason why they made a remake. Do you believe that they thought, okay, this is a story or a film that Malayalam audience need to watch? Because they would have probably missed watching Andhadhun. Because, you know, I can understand the fact that a lot of Malayalam people who do not understand Hindi might have missed Andhadhun. But that will be a very small proportion of people we are talking about. Because most of the people in Kerala, especially, you know, after having done all these podcasts and interacting with so many people from Kerala, I'm sure they understand their cinema. They know their cinema. So I'm sure they also watch good Hindi films without even knowing the language. They can definitely, you know, watch it with subtitles, just like we watch Malayalam cinema with subtitles. So just to cater that little percentage of people who might have missed Andhadhun, does that, do you think, is that a good enough reason to make Andhadhun again in Malayalam?
I don't know if that's a good enough reason, but it definitely sounds like a convenient one. I mean, the question that I think that we need to ask is, was this remake necessary? Could it have been done without a remake? I mean, the answer is yes. I mean, the second answer is yes. The first answer is no. You know, it wasn't required, the remake, and that too this soon. Andhadhun was out, I think, barely 3 years ago, I think in 2018. And within those 3 years, I think there's another, by the way, Tamil remake also that is coming out. Oh. It's going to be like a clean slate. I mean, it's going to be like a complete slate, rather. Telugu, Tamil and Malayalam remake. So, I mean,
I hope
somehow
Canada also doesn't come out with it now.
I hope so they don't, because it's not going to be easy, and you need some level of skills of the director. I mean, I have, by the way, I've written a review of Bhramam as well on my site, Popcorn Reviews. You can leave the link in the description, where I have specified that you need a director like Sriram Raghavan to actually pull off such a movie, you know, which has so many shocking moments or the dark humor. If you don't have that skill, it's not going to come out right. And this is exactly what happened. I mean, normally we talk about Malayalam cinema being, you know, absolutely top notch in terms of technicalities. But here, sorry to say, I mean, the technicalities were not up to the mark. The editing was a hot mess here. I mean, it was.
Do you think it's a thing of skill necessarily? Because I'm sure, I mean, the director Ravi K. Chandran has done good work also before. So, I mean, I'm not sure if it's a thing of skill, but it's probably something to do with picking a wrong film to remake.
I mean, yeah, I mean, I feel that even if you were remaking a film, even if you were remaking a film, I mean, Andhadhun has its own share of flaws as well. So what I was hoping is, especially the second half, you know, of Andhadhun wasn't as good as the first half. It was an excellent watch overall with a brilliant ending, but the second half was a little wobbly as well. And I, for one, I thought that they would be rectifying that mistake, you know, of not committing the same mistakes and, you know, probably opting for a different route with your own share of twists and turns after having the initial base set up. But nothing of that happened. I mean, this actually is a skill. I mean, I would beg to differ, you know, this is a skill in terms of your visualization as a director and your camera angles, where to put it, how much the editing should be, how quick, how crisp it should be. All that, it really suffered. I mean, the editing and the cinematography were bad.
Do you think that was because of the pressure of, you know, making the remake of a very, very hit film, of a film that has been probably universally accepted? So the pressure probably told on him?
The way I see it is that they were, I think, confused as to how much originality we should bring to this movie. You know, whether we should bring our own elements or whether we should make it like a frame-to-frame copy. Like, I have seen Maestro as well. And the same review, you'll find it on Popcorn as well, Popcorn Reviews. Maestro was a far more faithful remake because it was a shot-by-shot, frame-by-frame copy of Andhadhun. Yes, the dark humor was missing there. And if you had watched Andhadhun, you wouldn't really enjoy Maestro as well. But it was not a bad watch for me. I did not expect much from it. And I came out with, it was okay, one-time watch, you know, it's like not bad. But here, I think they were caught in that dilemma whether to add some originality. They added that instead of the rabbit, they added a boar. But it didn't really add anything. I feel the first section, if you see Andhadhun, it was, you know, slow-paced and it allowed the audience to judge the character and sink it in, you know. Here, it was such, very fast, you know, and it was a little disjointed, if I can say so. It wasn't as smooth.
When you say that Maestro was a more faithful remake because it was frame by frame copy. So if somebody is doing a frame by frame copy, then where is his own skill as a director? Like, I can understand you questioning the skill of the Malayalam director because, you know, it didn't, he couldn't execute it as well as, Sriram Raghavan. But when you say that Maestro is a more faithful remake, but in the same breath, you also say it's a frame by frame copy. So again, where do you see the skill of that director then?
So, I mean, the question that you have to ask, I think I'll circle back to the first question that you had asked, you know, that was this remake necessary? I think it would be catering to a very small audience. So if you're catering to that small audience particularly, then a frame-to-frame remake will definitely work because they haven't seen the original. But the moment, you know, you are trying to add your own elements and not successfully so as well, you know, just for the sake of adding basically and not adding anything to the scene, anything new, rather you're just adding some gimmicky factors. Like for example, coming to that rabbit scene again, rabbit scene in Andhadhun made a lot more sense than the boar scene, because that stick which you remember at the end of the film in Andhadhun, that had that head of a rabbit. That's where he got the idea from. But here there was no reference of the boar. It didn't have a head of a boar or anything. So it didn't really add up. Why did it have to be a boar then? Why not stick to a rabbit only? That was my question. So, I mean, and there are many such examples, you know, like they've just rushed through certain parts and elongated a certain scenes which weren't really required. You know, the halfway point, that scene in Andhadhun, if you see, it was like much more, sharply edited, basically. Here it was like meandering. There was a little more talk before the actual action that happened. Did it contribute to it? I don't think so. I mean, as I think many actors have said in many of the, I think Nawazuddin had once said on Actors Roundtable, I think it was Actors Roundtable with Rajiv Masan, he said that we've become more verbose in cinema. We don't need to be so verbose. So crisper we become, even with smaller gestures, if we are able to convey the point, then that is it. And this was exactly the opposite. There was more chatter, which didn't really add to the scene. It could have been, you know, condensed a little more, I feel. I think it was a little hit and a miss here.
Did you feel that in this film, if we compare, of course, we'll compare it with Andhadhun, it's a remake. So, Ray Matthews, did you think was a little bit more wicked than Akash in Andhadhun? Because, you know, the original story was about a man who's, you know, pretending to be blind to, you know, protect himself from whatever happened. And Ray, I felt that, you know, he also acted blind to exploit, you know, the social and economic benefits, you know, which are actually reserved for people with disabilities. So, you know, just for example, like how he was upset when he lost the teaching job. So because the other person has the gift of sight, but he doesn't. So did you feel that this guy, Ray Matthews, is a bit more selfish or self-centered or meaner compared to Akash, or even since you have seen Maestro, even that?
So Maestro, again, the character, I'm forgetting the character's name, was more similar to Ayushman's character, more closer to the original. But here, I do tend to agree that it did come across like it was a little selfish, that character, or I wouldn't say he was mean or rude in that sense, but selfish, yes. I mean, maybe. And I don't think this was the intended emotion when you probably would have started off with this character. I mean, the emotion that, you know, when I had watching Andhadhun, I didn't feel that, as you also rightly said, we didn't feel like the character was, selfish or anything. You know, he was that, there was this line that he had said in Andhadhun that this is just like an experiment that I'm trying to do, trying to act blind, which had no reference here whatsoever in Bhramam. And that should have had a reference, you know, that line added a lot of weight to what the character actually was. But here, I just feel that, I don't think they had intended him to make him selfish as such, but it did come across like that. And that was, I think, the way it is much to do with the director, I feel. The director should owe an explanation here as to why did he sketch the character out, like flesh out the character like being selfish, which wasn't really the need of the hour here. The public sympathy should have been with him. Yeah. And it was a bit of, as I said, it was a bit of a hit and a miss everywhere.
Yeah, I mean, see, one of the obvious things where the film has failed, and not just talking about Bhramam, but even Maestro, is to match the quality of performances that were, you know, given by Ayushman and Tabu. I mean, they had set the benchmark so high that, you know, it is, I don't think, maybe again, being biased toward Fahad Fasil, we will always say that he can pull off any role. But still, I mean, the camaraderie between Tabu and Ayushman in that film, you know, how they were reacting off each other, rubbing off the energy. So that kind of thing is so difficult to match. And just for that reason, I thought make, so even if they wanted to remake this classic, I mean, this at least, you know, this in a way tells us that just because the original is a hit in a different industry doesn't guarantee that it'll be a hit in another industry as well. Like I
Yeah.
remember they they remade Three Idiots in Tamil, I think, and it wasn't you know, received very well in South. Like I remember talking to one of my friends in Chennai when I was studying back there. So he told me people were not really excited by Three Idiots remake or even Delhi Belly remake. I mean, here it's a cult hit, and people are not too fascinated by that either. I think Queen was also remade just recently in multiple languages. I'm not sure how it was received there, but yeah, I mean, these are some examples. And even, it's the other way around as well. Like Vinay Thandi Varuvai is a, you know, such a beautiful film down south. It has, you know, a lot of value, and it's a milestone film for the director, for even A.R. Rahman, and given the soundtrack. But here, when it was made as Ek Deewana Tha, it completely it was rejected outrightly by audiences. So, do you also think it has something to do with the taste of audience of that particular region, that they might not accept and perceive the film as it was perceived by some other region, the people of other region?
Yeah, it could be. It could be because I think a few films are, you know, region specific, you know, the region where they're set in. So I do tend to agree that not all remakes would, but yeah, here again, I think here it was again set somewhere in Kerala, whereas Maestro was set in Goa. I think Andhadhun was in Mumbai itself, wasn't it?
Pune, I think.
Right. Okay, so it was somewhere in the west. It's a bit of yes and no. I mean, I don't think this particular movie is region specific, to be honest. I mean, it could have been a nice remake as well. But I mean, I don't think this probably would, I don't think we can attribute it to a region specific thing here specifically for this movie. I would say I agree with Delhi Belly example that you had given. That was a very so to say a North Indian story. I wouldn't want to go into the region and all, but that was a region specific. It had that flavor to it. And the moment you take the story out of that,
The cultural references were very
yeah,
normal.
the cultural references, exactly. That is what I meant. The cultural references. But here I think this could have been a nice remake had they introduced their own elements or taken a different route, taken the just a basic idea and weave their own story, which is something that I would have expected, probably not with the Telugu one, but the, definitely with the Malayalam one. So I mean, that is just that, yeah.
If for a moment we keep aside the amazing performances in the original, in standalone capacity, in isolation, how would you look at the performances of Prithviraj, Mamta Mohan Das, Shankar, and I mean, Rashi Khanna had not a lot to do here. I was not impressed with her even in Tughlaq Darbar. But the main three, how would you look at them in isolation?
Prithviraj, I think, was the best performer, although that doesn't speak anything about the level of performance. He was found wanting, to be honest. He's usually a very reliable actor, and we've seen him in Kuruti and Driving License, even Ayappanam Koshiyam.
Found wanting is because of the context here that it will always be compared with Ayushman, or even in isolation, you thought he was not up to the mark.
Even in isolation, I think a better director probably would have extracted a better performance, I would say. There are many, I think we also discussed, we touched upon that point that probably Fahad would have done. Who knows? Fahad also may have struggled if the direction wasn't great, you know, because the direction truly wasn't great. It didn't extract anything. Coming to Rashi Khanna, truly was flat. I mean, I really missed Radhika Apte. There was this charm to that character, you know, charm and that level of oomph that was there. And she was just flat here. Rashi Khanna was, I'm sorry, a very big disappointment, though she had not a very big role. And coming to Mamta Mohan Das, she was already on the back foot, you know, when she'd signed the film, because she was definitely pitted against Tabu, the great Tabu, who had brought so many shades into the original film. you know, that that scene in which she says aphrodisiac, that word that she says, that sounded so seductive in the first one. And here, I mean, it just was a put on laughter. It just felt so fake, you know. I mean, it was, Mamata Mohandas is not a bad actor, by the way. I've seen her in Forensic, which is a Malayalam film that I recommend. But somehow here, I mean, she was already on the back foot and she didn't rise to the occasion. I think I would go as far to say that Tamanna Bhatia, who was in Maestro, who played the same character, she did a better job. Although nowhere close to Tabu. Tabu is a legend. But she did a better job at least. I mean, there was some amount of takeaway from that character. But here it was just, I mean, and also I felt that if you see, the casting also wasn't great. The original had Tabu and Ayushman, who actually had that age difference. You could make out that age difference. It was meant to be that. But here, I mean, Prithviraj seemed to be elder than Mamata Mohandas. It just didn't match up to that, you know. So it's somewhere.
Maybe they thought this is the element of originality that we are bringing in.
Then they are mistaken then.
What about the role of Shankar, the yesteryear hero that he played?
I liked Anil Dhawan better. I think it was a far more honest and far more braver performance by Anil Dhawan. The way he says, "Ye kya mere liye aaye hai?" And you know, that actually had that sense of humor as well. Whereas here, it was just okay. I mean, it was like any other character. It wasn't, and I don't, to be honest, I haven't been a follower of his work. So I don't know what work he's done earlier. So I don't have a reference point to his yesteryear's performances that he has delivered. So it would be a little unfair for me to comment on that. But how much ever I saw, I felt that Anil Dhawan was a far more braver performance. And I would also attribute it, like, Ayushman is not a very great actor. He's also a little stereotyped. But this is probably one of his better performances of his career. It has to do with the director, Sriram Raghavan, which is why I feel that the better director would probably have extracted a better performance.
And, you know, for that reason, I sometimes feel when people are making remakes, they should always have the director of original on board as an executive producer or as a creative producer, anything in any capacity. They should have get them to supervise, so to say, because it will always add more value to the project, because what he can bring to the table, it will only enhance your product as well.
I think, Keshav, we cannot end without you talking about the music. I think you will be the best person to talk about and compare the music as well, and how Amit Trivedi was and how, you know, the music here was. So I think you will be the best person to comment on that.
Yeah, I mean, see, the thing with music is, first of all, okay, Amit Trivedi didn't do the background score, I'm guessing, of Andhadhun. Somebody else did it. He only did the songs. And here, see, again, because of the comparisons, we might not find the music in Bhramam as good as Andhadhun, especially the piano pieces. Although I felt in isolation, the piano pieces here were not that bad. They were, you know, apt for the movie. But again, the benchmark was so high, you know, in Andhadhun, in every department, that whatever you will compare with, whether it's Bhramam or it's Maestro, it'll come down.
It has a European touch to it as well, no? In Andhadhun, slightly.
Yeah, I mean, not European per se, but there is some Western touch to it. And see, it has also to do with the kind of playing that a particular pianist has. You know, the playfulness of a pianist can differ from one person to another. So I don't know who played the piano in this one. I know who played in Andhadhun, but I don't know who did in this one. See, individually, they did a good job. But it'll always come down to comparison. So that way, I think it'll always be the second best in the race. But yeah, I mean, music was such a huge, huge background music. I mean, was such a huge part in this story. So it'll always be under scanner, you know, whomsoever remakes it. So yeah, good for you. Good of you to, you know, point it out. I would have totally forgotten otherwise. So yeah, I mean, Now, as a as the founder of Popcorn Reviews, would you recommend people to watch Bhramam?
No, totally watch the original. The original is probably far better. That if you are comfortable with watching a movie with subtitles, if you don't understand Hindi, and you're okay with watching it with subtitles, definitely go for the original Andhadhun. And if you are not privy to that, then probably then you can give it a go, although with limited expectations. This is not a great remake. I wouldn't recommend it. And it is probably the law of averages has caught up, I think, with Malayalam cinema. It's been a fabulous year, and there are more fabulous releases that are coming up as well. But this is just one small blip on the report
There
card.
was another cold blip, if I would say. There's a cold case again,
Cold case.
starring
I
people.
didn't. It was okay for me. Yeah.
We had a couple of blips, but also a great film in Kurudi. But anyway, I mean, guys, just like we watch Malayalam films with subtitles and love them, and love to talk about them with you all. Same way, if you have not seen original and the Malayalam one, then do us a favor, go watch the Hindi one with subtitles and put down in the comments below what you felt about these films. And yeah, so thank you for watching. And I know that we have been promising for such a long time that we will come up with Ayyappanam Koshiyam, again another Prithviraj film, by the way. And
Yeah, both of
yeah, driving
them,
license.
driving license.
We are just not able to get time to do it because
This jinx, isn't it?
I mean, it's like, since it's an old film, you always keep them number second in the priority list, because whenever something new is coming, you have to prioritize that, because it's trending in a way. So, but don't worry, we will do it this month for sure. I won't say now this week or next week, because that puts more pressure on us. But we'll definitely do it. You guys also requested for Mahishinda Pratigaram and the other Prakashan, that film. So we'll definitely be covering that as well. We are back now with a bang. Hopefully, no more long gaps like earlier. So yeah, so keep subscribing. Like the video, please. That helps us reach more and more people. It helps us get the push in this YouTube algorithm. And yeah, thank you so much once again, Farhad, and thank you everyone for watching the video.
Again.
And see you very soon. Bye bye.